Hey, this is Ben here. Hope you're all having a lovely day. If it's your first time here, welcome to this channel. What I do is create CG or HLSL shaders within Unity. All right, so this video is actually gonna be a start of a new series. We're gonna do shaders without textures. And the reason why I kinda wanna do this is because I wanna showcase to you that you don't always have to use textures and texture mapping to, you know, to start doing your shading. So I'm gonna actually take texturing and even lighting out of the equation and really just kind of focus on simple math and all the cool different techniques that you can do without even textures. It'll help you understand some of the math, and exactly how shaders work. Cool. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to create a new shader file. This is the one where I went over in my last video. I was kind of going over every single line, what this shader is doing. There's a link in the card above if you need to go to that video. But here I'm going to go ahead and create a new shader, unlit shader like before, and we're going to call it, UV gradient. I'll show you what that means in a moment. Here I already have a UV gradient material. I'm going to go ahead and attach that UV gradient shader. But first, we need to put this in the folder I've been using is called introduction, but I don't know if I will keep it that way. I'm going to save that off, and now you can see here in the inspector under introduction is UV gradient. Cool. All right, I'm going to quickly remove all of the fog math. We don't need any of that. I'm going to leave UV text though. Main text though. Cool. So as you can see, I've trimmed down this shader. I've removed all of the fog, all of the math or shading that's related to fog. To do a very quick demonstration, I just wanted to show you what UVs are used for. UVs are usually used for sampling textures. So for example, I have a texture here I got from Pixel Bay. It's just an eye here. And what's happening is Unity is running this line right here, text2d main text underscore i.uv. This is the variable that we care about. I just wanted to show you quickly that this is usually typically used for sampling textures, but it doesn't have to be. We can actually take this and kind of do our own manipulation to it, because after all, this is a series about shaders without textures. So we're going to first remove this texture. To do that, I'm actually going to go ahead and just remove all of the texture main text related code. I'm going to leave UV here and here. As you know from the past lesson, I mentioned that app data is the object data or the mesh data. Right now we have the vertex position and the UV data coming from the object. It's going to be sent to the V2F, vertifrag, the fragment, the vertex shader is going to assign the vertex here, and we're going to directly assign the UV here. So we're going to leave all of this alone. We don't need main text here. I'm going to remove that. This will stay alone, and I'm also going to get rid of main text. This text2D is how we sampled this texture, but again, we're not going to look into that right now. Now UV is a float too, as you can see right here. It's a float too. It means it's, you can think of it as a vertex with two variables, with an X and a Y. So in order for us to display it, it would look something like this. I'm going to put fixed four because this fragment shader requires a fixed four, but we can put i.uv.xy. So the first two variables of this float two, comma zero, comma one. If I save this off, it looks something like this. Now what's happening here is I'm putting i.uv.x into the red channel, y into the green channel, zero into the blue, and one in the alpha. To one more thing, because this is a float two, we actually don't need X and Y here. I can just kind of do this. If I save this off, go back here, it should recompile with no errors. Another thing shaders can do is not just do X and Y. We can also do something called X and X. Oops. What this means is now we're putting the x value of this UV into the red, green, and blue channels. So if I save this off, I'll get this gradient. So what it's telling us is that the x value or the U value is going from 0 to 1. So when I print out shaders or when I display shaders, what I'm trying to do is trying to get an idea of what is happening here in this shader. Right now we're spitting out white, or we're spitting out just this, the X value within the UV, and it's spitting out from 0 to 1 along this X axis. I guess you can think of it as that way. Now, we also have a Y. I can also do this. If I save this off, it will now go into this axis, starting from 0, going up to 1, right? So now we're kind of displaying what is happening here on this quad from the shader just with X and Y. That is why when we put X and Y here and a 0 here, now we're going to ignore the blue. The X becomes red, right? That's why it's going from 0 to red here. And the green becomes is the Y. That's why it's going from 0 to more and more green as we go up here. The reason why it's yellow over here is because this is both 1 in red and 1 in green. I hope that makes sense. Remember how I said the vertex and fragment, UV really is just a piece of data coming in from the mesh. We can display it as color, we can manipulate it and do what we want with it. We don't actually have to use it to sample textures. It typically is used to sample textures, but we don't have to use it that way. We can use it to create a gradient. So let's go ahead and do that. So I mentioned last time how to create a property is underscore color is just the way I like to name it, but it can be just color. So we'll call it gradient color. Anytime we create a new color, we got to make sure we declare it here so that we can use it. If we go back to Unity, we see our gradient color here. It's now ready for us to use. It doesn't do anything right now. The first thing I want to do is I'm going to display just the X value. Oops, this mistake happened because there are too many variables. This is a fixed 4, but there's actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 variables here. So I have 1x too many. Or actually, I want to leave the x here and I want to get rid of that 0. So now we go back to this gradient from black to white. So what if whenever it is white, we want to show this color? Well, the simple thing that we can do is we can actually just multiply it. That will give us a gradient going from black to the color that we've selected. Pretty cool, but what if we want two colors? Let's go ahead and add a second one. I'm just gonna go ahead and take this and copy and paste it. I'll call this color 1 and color 2. Need to rename this one to 1. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to teach you guys is something called interpolation. We're going to lerp it in the fragment shader from one value to another based on X. So lerp is commonly used in Unity as well. So in CG code, it looks something like this. The first parameter here is the color that we want to start from, then the color we want to lerp to, and a variable we want to lerp by. So now we don't need any of this up here. In fact, I can just do this. I'm going to scroll it over so it's easier to see. Cool. I'm going to save that off. All right, so now it's set to white and white. So we can go from red to blue if we want. and the colors in the between will mix properly. We can change it to Y. If we change it to Y, what will happen is it will go top down, right? Cool, and that is it for a very simple gradient shader using the UVs. The next thing I want to show you is an optimization trick. And this is an optimization that is kind of like the rule for all rendering engineers and for all people writing shaders. Whenever possible, because like I said, the fragment runs on every single pixel on screen, it's running a lot of times right here on screen. It's running on every single pixel down this quad, right? If it's possible to move math to the vertex shader, always do so, because the vertex shader in this specific case only runs four times, 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? I know there's models that can be very densely vertexed, but most of the time there will always be more pixels on screen than vertices. So how do I move this to the vertex shader? I'm going to show you something real cool in the vertex shader right now that'll help me better explain that. All right, so the first thing I want to do is, if I want to generate a color in a vertex shader, I need to create a new variable for me to use, and I'm going to call it color. I'm going to use a float for higher precision. I'm going to call it color, and I'm going to use text chord. Now, in order for me to pass data from the vert to the fragment, we need to use text chords. Sometimes there are other variables like normals here, but I think I'll touch base on that when I get there. Right here, we can't use text chord 0 because it's being used here in the UV. What we need to do is use this, text chord 1. And I believe text chord goes from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, right? And I think on certain devices, there's actually a cap on it. So you cannot go past, I'm not sure if it's 8 or 10, which is the max limit. But especially on certain mobile devices, the limit is actually quite low. I think it's only 8 on certain ones. But in this case, we're going to use text chord 1. So now that it is set, what we can do is here, I can do o.color, because I have it up there in the V2F, is equal to V.uv. Now I realize I'm assigning the same thing twice, but I'm doing that on purpose to show you something. Next, what I want to do is display the O.color, and in this case it will be I.color. So, in fact, actually we don't even need a fixed 4 because this color is a float 4, so we don't need that. I can just go straight to I.color. I think this will actually throw an error. And the reason why is because this is a float 4 and I'm trying to force it into a float 2. I'm trying to use a float 2 to assign it to a float 4. So let's not do that. Oops. Of course, this is not a float 4, I had 2, this is a float 4. All right, so we're back to what we had before. We are assigning the color, we're just kind of going straight here. We're just kind of displaying it. In fact, I don't even need to declare color there. I can just go straight to return i.color, right? So now we're returning and we're doing all of the math up here. Now, earlier I said this was run 4 times and yet we're seeing this gradient here. How does that happen? The reason is because one of the biggest things that a vertex shader does is that once the value is set here, it actually interpolates up to here. It interpolates linearly within the vertex shader. So if I had a more complicated object, so let's just say I'm going to go up here and create a few things. I'm going to create a cube. I'm going to actually apply this material to all of them. The sphere, as you can see, it actually, the UVs kind of wrap around it, almost like the texture is being wrapped around it. And the cube has, you know, almost like a plane on every side, right? Kind of like so. All right, so back to what I was saying before. It's being interpolated for every single vertex. In this case, it's being ran four times. It's being interpolated from here to here, 0 to 1. This plane, on the other hand, however, has like, I believe almost 10 boxes here. I'm not sure exactly, but let's say it's 10. But what it's doing is interpolating from 0 to 0.1, 0.1 to 0.2, so forth, all the way up to 1. That's what's happening here. So the vertex shader, it does interpolation for the fragment shader. So when the fragment shader outputs this color, it's already interpolated. So we can take advantage of this interpolation earlier when we were doing our gradients. All we got to do is actually do the gradient math up here instead of down there. So we can actually do the lerp here instead. So let's put the lerp math back here. All right, so now that I've put it back, we can go ahead and, because this material is attached to all of them, I believe changing one will change all, right? And there you go. You have now a very basic gradient shader that is ran in the vertices, not in the fragment. And yeah, I think that is it for this particular lesson. I know this seems very simple, but I just wanted to start off simple so that I can, you know, kind of slowly work my way to more and more complicated things in the future. So if you guys like what you see, I ask that you subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you all next time. Bye now.